Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we'll be working on some basic login commands, features, such as whenever a message is edited, deleted, a channel is created or deleted, and when a member is updated, such as when their roles, nickname change. So before we do this, you want to go to the developer portal and ensure that you have server members intents on and message content intent. Okay, now let's go to the code. So we want to import Discord. I'll be using Pycord for this, but this should also work for Discord PY. You just may have to make some moderate adjustments. Then we want to import datetime. So from datetime, import datetimes. This is for our timestamps. Then we can do bot equals discord.bot. And then we can do intents. Intents equals discord.intents.default. And we want to have our privileged intents, intents.members. Members equals true, intents.messages equals true. Okay, and we can have intents equals intents. All right, now let's go on to our first event. This will be on message delete. This is called whenever a message is deleted. So let's get a channel first, our login channel. For public bots, you can use find or some other method, or use a database to store logging channels to different servers, but in our case we'll just be doing it locally, so I'll just use a channel ID. Okay, and then we can do embed equals discord.embed, title equals, we'll just say the author's message.author message was deleted. Okay, and description equals, you just do the content, deleted message. This will be message.content. And we can do author. Author is the message.author.mention. So we'll mention the author, but they won't get a ping or anything. And channel or location is message.channel.mention. Okay. And let's work on timestamps. So timestamp equals datetime.now. And color equals discord.color dot red. Okay, and we can do await z.send embed equals embed. All right, next one, let's do on message edit now. Async dev on message edit before and after. And we can really just copy this and modify it. So we can do just do before.author, it doesn't really matter. Was edited their message. Okay, edited their message. Okay, and description is before and after, so the before content and after content. This can be called, a message edit can be called for different reasons, such as when a message's content is changed or if it's pinned or unpinned. On the screen, I'll leave some information on that. We can do before.author.mention, and we want after, so after is after.content. Author is going to be the same regardless, so we can do before or after, it doesn't really matter. Before.channel.mention, timestamp now, color is, we can just do blue. And embed is embed. So let's create another event. So this one is going to be a little bit more complicated. This would be on member update. This is called whenever a member is updated, such as their nicknames, roles, or pending status changes. So let's check for roles first. So if len, so number of before roles, is greater than len after dot roles. So this means that a role has been removed, right? So role equals next. Role for role in before dot roles. If role not in after dot roles. Yes? Yeah. And then we can do embed equals discord.embed. Okay. And title can just equal, let's just do before dot authors. Role has been removed. Something like that. It really doesn't matter as long as it conveys the message. Then we can do role.name was removed from before.author.mention. Okay, and we can just do the same thing here, same timestamp, just color red, etc. And that works. Okay, next one, alif. This is important. You want to use alif. Len, but after dot rolls. After dot rolls is greater than len before dot rolls. Okay. Then we basically can copy the same thing except we invert it, right? So roll for roll in after dot rolls, if not in before dot rolls. Okay. And we can say author. Say got a new role, okay, and you can say role.name was added to before.author.mention, and we can make this green. Okay, let's do another circumstance. Alif before.nick does not equal after.nick, so that means nickname has been changed. We can do, I do not want to open a terminal, embed, we can just do before dot author's nickname changed. Okay, very simple. Okay, so we can do before equals before dot nick, right? We don't want nick, we want nick. So this is the nickname, and after is after dot nick. And we don't really need any of the stuff behind this. We have timestamps and a color. We can just make this blue. Okay. And we can do else. So this else occurs if it's pending status changes. It's not really relevant. So we can just do else. We can use else return. And let's just do embed.setAuthor. Name equals before.name. Or actually, let's just do after.name. It doesn't really matter. It's just that it's just a matter of preference. Icon URL equals after.displayAvatar. So I think for Discord PY, this the display avatar is different. You have to look at their docs. Don't really recall, but I do believe it is different. Okay, and we can also do this for a message delete. We'll just do message dot. Dot name and message dot author dot display avatar. Okay, and then we can do await z. Okay, we need to do get await z dot send embed equals embed. Okay, all right, now let's work on channels. Okay, so async def on guild, if I can spell it, channel. Let's just do create. We can do channel. And we can just do get, right? Except we don't have an author. We can just do a channel. Okay, we can just do channel, the channel name. Channel was created. Actually, let's make this channel.name. Okay, and we can mention the channel. So if anyone wants to click the link, they can, like, click the mention, go to that channel. So this will be channel.mention. Timestamp now, we can make this green. And that's it, very simple. Okay, let's do another event. This one will be async def on guild channel delete. Okay, and channel. We can really just copy this, right? Again, except we'll invert it. Okay, and was deleted, and you don't want to mention it because it'll just say deleted channel, and we can make this red. Okay, we're basically done now, so we can do bot.run and then we want a token. So let's go to our developer portal, copy the token, and there we go. Let's run the code and see if we get any errors. Say I try to do delete. It's logged it, edit. It logs it. Looks looks like we got an issue here. Message has no object name. So after dot message object has no attribute. After dot author name, after dot author dot display. And let's run that again. Okay, let's try to do edit, delete, and create a channel. Let's show all tests. And it's been mentioned, see? And if we delete, it says channel deleted. If I mess with my roles, say I remove a role, it says, oh, looks like we got an error. Member has no attribute author. Let's see. Which line? 29. So line 29, member before. Okay, oops, it's not author, it's just before. Okay, we'll just replace that really quickly. Not a big deal. And let's remove this before it causes more issues, as well as here. And let's run it again. Okay, let's try this again. If I say add the role. Okay, B says got a new role, Digiwind was added. We remove, it works. I'm just gonna add it back. And if I change my nickname, say I change it to, I don't know, one. It says nickname was changed. Before is none, after is one. If you have any questions, feel free to comment down below or join our Discord. We'll help you with your code or any questions you have in the Python channel. And if you found this video helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing. It'll help out the channel. Thanks for watching.